CIET-NCERT presents curriculum based series Dhwani Shala. So let's join in Dhwani Shala class 2.
Hello dear children, how are you all? I am your friend Varada. You and I will be talking in English. It's nice to talk in English and quite easy too. Did you say difficult? No, not at all. I promise you. If you listen carefully to all that I say, you will easily understand everything. Let's talk about school. Oh, wait. You don't go to school now because of the coronavirus. Don't worry. After some time, schools will reopen. How exciting it will be to go back to school, to sit at your own desk and meet all your friends, speak to your teacher and learn many more new things. There will be a few changes, of course. You and your friends and your teachers will all be wearing masks. But that is only to keep you safe. Do you remember a time when you did not have school? I mean, even before you came to class 1, when you were still very small. Some of you may have gone to nursery and KG classes. Some of you may have come directly to class 1. That's all right. And do you remember your first lunchbox? What color was it? Red? Yellow? Blue? Did someone say green? Okay, and what about the shape? Was it round or square? Did it have a spoon inside? And I'm sure you carried a water bottle. A nice water bottle that you could hold in your hand or hang from your shoulder. Do you still have it? But this time, when you go to school, you will be very careful. You should not drink water from anybody else's bottle, but only from your own water bottle. Promise me that. Yes. Now let's listen together to a poem on a child's first day at school.
Children, I will now recite this poem. It is called First Day at School. I wonder if my drawing will be as good as theirs. I wonder if they like me or just be full of stares. I wonder if my teacher will look like mom or gran. I wonder if my puppy will wonder where I am. And now, our little friend will recite the same poem.
First day at school. I wonder if my drawing will be as good as theirs. I wonder if they like me or just be full of stares. I wonder if my teacher will look like mom or gran. I wonder if my puppy will wonder where I am.
And now, children, let us listen to the tune played on the piano and guitar. Now, children, let us sing out this poem. Ready? I wonder if my drawing will be as good as theirs. I wonder if they'll like me or just be full of stares.
I wonder if my
like mom or gran. I wonder if my puppy will wonder where I am.
I wonder if my teacher will look like mom or gran. I wonder if my puppy will wonder where I am. La 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 la.
Yes, children, I'm back again. I was talking to my small friend. She is my neighbor. She is just 5 years old. She is called Lei. Her parents have told her that she will be going to school soon and she is very excited. Last week, her parents bought her a new school bag, a new lunchbox, and a new water bottle. She was really happy. But today, she came to me. She sat down. She was very quiet. Then she said, "I will go to the school, but I don't know my teacher." I said, "That's all right. Your teacher will take care of you. You will like her." She sat quietly for some time again. Then she said, "How will I know where to sit in the class?" Again, I said, "Don't worry, the teacher will tell you." Lei looked at me again. Then she said in a small voice, "And if I want to go to the bathroom, whom should I ask? How will I know where the bathroom is?" I smiled at her. "Your teacher will tell you. Your friends will show you where the bathroom is. They will all take care of you." "Oh," she said. "And will they become my friends?" I said, "Yes, of course." Her face looked happy again. And then she said, "Thank you. Bye." Now, children, in the poem also, the child was wondering whether his drawing will be good, other children will play with him, whether he will like the teacher or not, and so on. But there's really nothing to worry. Now that you are in class 2, you have already seen that there is nothing to worry. And when you go back to school, it will be once again a happy time. Now, before you go to school every day, what do you have to do? Yes, you take a bath, you wash your face, yes. Now let's listen together to a poem.
Children, this poem is called After a Bath. Let's recite it. Are you ready?
Ready!
All right. After my bath, I try to wipe myself till I'm dry. Now repeat it. Ready? After my bath, I try to wipe myself till I'm dry. Hands to wipe, and fingers and toes, and two wet legs and a shiny nose.
Hands to wipe, and fingers and toes, and two wet legs and a shiny nose.
Just think how much less time I'd take if I were a dog and could shake.
Just think how much less time I'd take if I were a dog and could shake.
After my bath, I try to wipe myself till I'm dry. Sing along.
After my bath, I try to wipe myself till I'm dry.
And two wet legs and a shiny nose.
Hands to wipe and fingers and toes. And two wet legs and a shiny nose.
Just think how much less time I'd take if I were a
Yes, children, I'm back again. Before taking a bath, when you get up, what should you do? Yes, you have to brush your teeth. You have to brush your teeth really properly, once in the morning and once at night. So let's listen to a poem that tells you the things that you have to do before you go to school. And this poem begins with brush, brush, brush your teeth. So let's sing along with the poem.
Brush, brush, brush your teeth. Brush them every day. Father, mother, brother, sister, brush them every day.
Brush, brush, brush your teeth. Brush them every day. Father, mother, brother, sister, brush them every day.
Comb, comb, comb your hair. Comb it every day. Father, mother, brother, sister, comb it every day.
Comb, comb, comb your hair. Comb it every day. Father, mother, brother, sister, comb it every day.
Wash, wash, wash your face. Wash it every day. Father, mother, brother, sister, wash it every day.
Wash, wash, wash your face. Wash it every day. Father, mother, brother, sister, wash it every day.
After you wash your face, after you brush your teeth, after you comb your hair, you wear your uniform. A uniform is a special dress that you wear when you go to school. What color is your uniform? Oh my goodness, so many answers. Some of you say that your uniform is white and blue. Very smart. Oh, and somebody said yellow and brown. Very nice. And some others have checks pattern on their uniform. How wonderful. But whatever uniform you have, make sure that it is neat and clean. The child in the poem is wearing a clean uniform, holding a water bottle and going to school, yet the child keeps thinking whether his or her drawing will be good enough. Will all the other children stare at me? How will my teacher be? The child also has a puppy at home. Maybe the puppy is thinking of the child and wondering where he or she is. And when the child will finally return home, who waits for you when you return from school? Who opens the door for you? Your mother, sister, grandfather perhaps? And do you have a pet dog or puppy or cat that greets you? I'm sure after school, you would be hungry too. Maybe you eat biscuits or rusks or rotis or bread. But of course, remember to wash your hands before touching anything. Also, wash your hands after eating and rinse your mouth well. Now let's list out all the items that you put in your school bag. I will read the names of some items. If it is correct, shout yes. If it is not to go in your school bag, shout no. Shall I begin then? Pencil? Yes. Book? Yes. Bicycle? No. That won't fit in the school bag, will it? Okay. Lunchbox? Yes. Pet dog? No. You can't take a pet dog to school. Okay. Sharpener? Yes, certainly. Yes, you will need a sharpener for your pencil when you use the pencil in your school. Ice cream cone? No, no, children. if you keep ice cream in your school bag, what will happen? It will all melt. And then you have to wash your school bag. So, don't keep ice cream in your school bag. Small stones? No. What will you do with stones in school? Books? Yes. Toys? No. Water bottle? Well, you have to take it to school, but you should carry it in your hand. Suppose the water spills on your books, it won't be nice, will it? Okay. So now, keep your school bag clean, keep your things inside, and let's go to school as soon as possible. So children, let's listen to the poem again and sing along.
Now, children, let us sing out this poem. Ready? I wonder if my drawing will be as good as theirs. I wonder if they'll like me or just be full of stares.
I wonder if my drawing will be as good as theirs. I wonder if they'll like me or just be full of stares.
I wonder if my teacher will look like mom or gran. I wonder if my puppy will wonder where I am.
I wonder if my teacher will look like mom or gran. I wonder if my puppy will wonder where I am. La 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 la.
Yes, I'm sure you enjoyed the poem. So, shall I say bye now? Stay at home, stay safe, and wash your hands frequently. Goodbye, children.
You were just listening to curriculum-based programs, Dhwani Shala. Production assistants, Meenakshi Kukreti, Tanu Gupta, and Jagbandhu Jana. Recorded by Bati Langlingdo and produced by Ajit Horo. This program was brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.